Hello YouTube, Hot Lad Retired here. I just gotta clear up something. I'm getting a lot of hate, and it's about the video I did about building a wall and making Mexico pay for it. And it's mostly Mexicans, as you can understand. And they're calling me a racist, man, and they're wrong. And anyway, I don't care. Because most of them saying that are illegals and they're not even US citizens, so it don't bother me. But anyway, just to clarify the whole situation, I made a video. I don't know what it was, an earlier video, but I looked up all the statistics from the US Department of Transportation Bureau of Statistics. And they have a year's worth of statistics from every year, all the way up to 2014, I believe, or 15, of traffic entering the United States from Mexico. And I'm talking it's foot traffic, it's a vehicle traffic, it's freight traffic, it's even train traffic. And I didn't even know they had a train coming from Mexico. But anyway, you would be surprised at how many millions of people cross that border every day. All right. And of course, not all of them's Mexicans. Okay? But a big part of them is Mexican. All right. For this video, I'm going to explain how Mexico will pay for the wall. And it's just three ideas that I came up with, and I know Donald Trump knows more than that because I haven't even dug into it that deep. All right. Number one, with all these people coming across the border every day, we charge an entry fee. And just to keep it fair and unbiased and non-racist, we just charge everybody. I don't care if they're American, Canadian, Chinese, Japanese, Philippines, Korean, or whatever, English, European, or Mexican. They will all pay an entry fee. Everybody will pay an entry fee. There you go. $20. That's over $1 billion a year. I got the numbers in my other video. I don't have them with me here, so I'm just generalizing everything. All right, that's one way. Number two is like Trump says, we have a $58 billion trade deficit with Mexico. So that means we're losing money trading with Mexico. And I get people saying, well, if Trump charges tariffs and taxes on stuff coming to and from Mexico, products, it would cause a trade war. Well, we're already in a trade war. We're losing $58 billion a year. That's not even trading in my book. That's getting ripped off. We're getting ripped off. We are. We could stop trading with Mexico and actually lose less money. Not make a profit, but we can lose less money by stop trading with Mexico until we get to the, till we get to zero, and then we start losing money. But right now we're in the hole at $58 billion a year. It doesn't make sense. So yeah, bring it up even, charge tax, charge tariffs, bring it more to the center. All right, that's two, three. All these, now this is all legal immigrants working in the United States from Mexico, or a matter of fact, any country, China, whatever, that's working legally over here with a visa. They send billions of dollars a year back to their home country, to their families, and they use wireless transfers like Western Union, and there's a countless other fly-by-night wire networks out there. So we need to start charging $5 or $10 per hundred on all the money coming out of this country going into another country. And I heard somebody say, well, we already charge. Well, we need to charge 5 or 10 more. We need to up it. And that money there could go toward the wall. And that's billions of dollars a year. All right, there you go. And I've seen it happen, man. Where I worked at, we had this contractor that had like they were doing roof, putting a roof, new roof on buildings. And there was like 8 or 10 Chinese working over here on a work visa, couldn't speak English, couldn't even talk to them. And they sat around in a hotel room paid for by the company, eating rice out of a crock pot for like 3 months so they could save every penny they got off the government because it was a government contracting job. And they sent everybody that money back to China, man. Western Union at Walmart. So there you go, because I know. I seen it happen. I was there. All right. And that's just a group of 10 people. And I don't know how much money they sent back. They probably didn't send back a whole lot, but I know the contract was a pretty, in the millions, a dollar contract. Because I think it was like 5 or 6 buildings they had to re-roof. And I'm talking about, you know, they were 3 and 4 story buildings. They wasn't like a little grass hut on Gilligan's Island or anything like that. All right. Well, anyway. All right. While I'm on the topic, there's 11 million illegal aliens in this country. Probably more, but estimate 11 million. All right. And they say it's impossible to deport them all, which it's not going to be easy, but it can be done. And one thing we need to do is let it be known if they turn themselves in and we deport them, they can enter the United States in the future through legal means. And I'm talking passport, work visas, or become a U.S. citizen, or any legal reason to come in here. They will be allowed to do that. But if they don't turn themselves in, and we got to do a time frame. We got to give them like 6 months or a year or something. We got to give them a time frame. After that period of time, we catch them, and I'm talking about catching them committing crimes or whatever. Just catch them. One, if a law enforcement agency catches them, we cannot let them go. We need to prosecute them. All right. If it's past the date of self-deportation, they automatically get a 10-year sentence. And if they commit a crime, they got caught committing a crime, they pull the time for that crime plus the 10-year sentence. All right. We can knock half the sentence off if they work on the wall. There you go. All right. Now, if they turn themselves in, like I said, they can come back into the country in a future. They have the option to do that legally. All right. Now, these anchor babies. If 2 illegal aliens come to this country and mama squirts out a baby across the border in the U.S., it's a U.S. citizen as of now. All right. Here's what we do on that. We give them time to come forward too. And if they do, we'll deport them. But they have to take the kid with them if they're going to self-deport. It's their own choice. And then they can all enter the United States legally in the future. Visa, passport, whatever. A U.S. citizen, whatever. All right. If they don't turn themselves in, and we find them, they automatically, the parents get deported. They can leave the kid in America, and we can raise the kid as an American citizen, because he's an American citizen, till he's 18, and then he can go on his merry way. All right. And plus, they forfeit all future options to enter this country legally. And I'm talking about coming in here on a passport to visit their grandkids, crossing the border to see their uncle or cousin in Texas on a work visa. They cannot do any of that. If they get caught doing that, they go to jail for 10 years. And they can work on the wall. So there you go. Anchor baby problem solved. You know. And if they decide to take their kid with them back to Mexico, they can enter the country legally in the future by going through the legal process, passport, visa, whatever. So there you go. Anchor baby problem solved, and it's not against the Fourth Amendment because we're not deporting the kids. We're deporting the parents. And then I hear all you bleeding hearts out there, well, it'll bust up families. Well, if the family wants to bust up, then that's what they have the choice to do that. There you go. And if they do that, they're not much of a parent anyway, and they don't need a kid. Thanks for watching.